What's going on, guys? Brandon here, Mitten Bay Properties. We have your Wayne County real estate market update for November 2020. Let's jump right in. This always preface with two things. We have 3 years of data that we can see the trend. The trend is your friend. We want to be able to see what's going on here. 1 year of data would not make any sense. And then we have November because the data is fresh. It's in, it's hot off the press, and we're ready to go. So let's jump right into this. We have days on market. We have 40 days on market 2 years ago, 42 last year, and 36 this year. So we're seeing that across the board in Metro Detroit. We're seeing a decrease in the amount of time on the market, which is really to be expected. That's something that we are going to see going forward, probably for the foreseeable future, really indefinitely. Active homes in the market, this is the number, is a one-day data sample. So how many homes were on the market at that given time when the data was taken? 5,592 2 years ago, 5,652 last year, and then 3,411 this year. So a big decrease. We're seeing this again across the board, a big decrease of homes in the market. You're gonna see these numbers bear out a little bit more here. And months of inventory, 3 months of inventory 2 years ago, 3.6 last year, and then 1.76. We're seeing it cut in half, just like Oakland County was. The months of inventory cut in half. This is an incredibly deep seller's market. And just to give you context, 1 to 3 months is a seller's market. 4 to 6 months is a buyer, 4 to 6 months is a balanced market. And then 7 plus is a buyer's market, meaning there's a ton of homes in the market and home and prices are coming down on homes. This just shows you, obviously, why buyers are fighting over homes. There's not a lot out there and why prices are going up here, which we're gonna see in a moment. Number of new homes in the market. This is the number of homes that actually come onto market in the last month total, so it's a month-wide number, 2,825 2 years ago, 2,482 last year, and then 2,134 this year. So again, we're seeing a little bit of a decrease. The counties are a little bit all over with this, but they're about the same. They've been giving us about the same number throughout, so not gonna be much change going forward. Some of them have been lower, like this one. So again, expect to see less homes in the market, less available. Not good for buyers, great for sellers. If you're a first-time home buyer, gonna be tough, gonna be tricky. If you are a seller, it's gonna be tough to go find something unless you're going to rent with someone or you're going to move out of state or you're downsizing maybe or something like that. But just be wary of that. This is why we do this, so that way you can make the best decisions for you and your family. Price per square foot, $89 a square foot 2 years ago, $94 last year, then $115 this year. So again, across the board, you can see that increase in equity. This is why we do this, because this is a countywide number. It doesn't mean a ton when you're looking at it just from, hey, multiply your square footage, buy this, and you're gonna get your approximate value. Remember, this is a countywide number. If you want a true assessment on your home, you have to have someone on our team or an appraiser, someone to really get over and actually give you a valuation on your specific neighborhood and your specific home or your property. Sold, this is the last one here. This is kind of the buyer statistic. How many people actually sold their house, actually sat at a table and actually closed on a home? 1,678 2 years ago, 1,575 last year, and then 1,937 this year. This is the one where we've seen an increase really across the board in all the counties. We're seeing that the glut of homes finally start to run its course. Everything was stopped up in the spring and summer. Now things are starting to kind of finally sell, working their way through the system. I expect that number to go lower, probably drop below these previous year's numbers starting in January, February, March, because we got way less on the market and way less going on the market going forward as well, as you can see in this number and this number. So I appreciate you guys a ton for tuning in. Your time, your attention, your energy is the most important thing we have. Feed the mind with the time we have. And this is why we do this. This is why we've been doing this for 5 years. That way we can give you the best data possible. We have a catalog for people to be able to go back and see what is truly going on over time in each county in Metro Detroit. So appreciate you guys more than you know. And if you're on the podcast, at Legacy Group MI, at Legacy Group MI on Facebook and YouTube, put your questions, comments, concerns there, see what's going on, and we'll get to them as soon as we can. We appreciate you guys, and we'll see you on the next one.